Hey guys, so in this video I'm just going to ramble on about talking to teenagers about topics of sexuality. So that's kind of a mouthful, but teenagers, sex, and adults talking about it. I know it's kind of an awkward, uncomfortable thing for many adults to do. It's kind of the thing where, and by teenagers, I'm really thinking about, 13-year-olds, even 12-year-olds and 14-year-olds and 15-year-olds. You know, by the time they're 16 and 17 or 18, maybe it's not as such a big deal. And that's why many of the adults are like, I feel more comfortable waiting until they're 16 or 17 to talk about this kind of stuff. Which is a valid feeling to have, but I want to kind of challenge that notion, because by the time they get to 16 or 17, the discussion no longer matters as much. So my whole point of this ramble really is to say this. It's important, really, really important as an adult to have discussions to teenagers about topics of sexuality. It's uncomfortable, it's icky, I don't know why in this American culture is so taboo, but it is. Get over it. Get over it and talk to kids about it. And realize that sexuality as a topic is this gigantic, broad topic. It's not just about sexual intercourse and all the weird kind of stuff that entails, what if a kid asks about, anal sex or oral sex? How do you deal with that? And that can be pretty uncomfortable. But there are topics of sexuality which are maybe less, more comfortable to talk about. For example, what creates, what is intimacy? How do you connect to a different person? Just talking about what do you look for, if you were to have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, what is it that you look for? That's still a topic of sexuality. What could be a little more uncomfortable, and maybe the kids will not be willing to disclose or share, and that's totally fine. You want it, the most important thing, I think, when talking to teenagers about sexuality is just having the safe space for them to talk about it or not if they don't want to. So my high school just started this program. I wouldn't say program, but it's more like kind of 6-week advisory course discussion agenda, I would say. Every week, the kids will meet up in their advisory classes, and the teachers will kind of facilitate. And I, as a social work intern, and there's other social workers, will aid the teachers in leading and facilitating these discussions. But that's really it. Having a discussion with teenagers is extremely important, and letting them know that it's a safe space to talk about it. There's all kinds of weird questions that they might have that they might not feel comfortable asking directly about. In that case, they can... drop something. They can take a piece of paper, write it down anonymously, put in the question box, and then later on, the teacher can kind of just read that question and discuss it as a group, so that no one knows who asked that. And there are some instances where I don't want, kid will be like, I don't want to talk about that. Fine, respect that privacy and then not talk about it. When somebody shares a really intimate detail, so for example, I hope this doesn't happen, but it can happen in a group like this where the kid is like, when I was 5 years old, my uncle kind of took me to bed and touched my breast and my private area a lot, and so I was molested as a kid. That kind of personal detail could possibly be shared in a group like this, and again, this is why a topic of sexuality is so like, oh my gosh, I don't want to talk to teenagers about this. This is where the feeling comes from, because there's a lot of heavy topics that gets involved with this topic. In a situation like that, it's important for the group to have known beforehand, before this was even discussed. The first thing to discuss, of course, is that everything that is discussed in this room stays in this room. That is confidential, and every member in that group should make sure to respect it and not to spread rumors, not to judge each other, or to... to laugh at each other or to name call each other for whatever they share. Sometimes it can happen that somebody says something and it's really, they didn't mean it, but it ends up hurting someone or being insensitive and being offending someone. then this is also a space where a person who was offended can come out and say, hey, what you just said now hurt my feelings. And it could be an open forum to discuss why that was offensive, or why the person who said it didn't think it was offensive. You know, an open forum for a discussion like this is extremely important, because I feel like what happens with this topic in teenagers is this. It's pretty much what happened with me and a lot of my friends. In junior high, the only thing that the only time that we talked about sexuality with adults was the health class and sexual education class. And those classes are generally classes where an adult, a teacher, or, you know, a health teacher would just lecture to you. You know, these are the diseases you can get by having sex. You can get pregnant, and these are the horrible things that can happen when you're a teenager and pregnant. So the only message that you get just drilled into your head and you get scared into thinking is, oh my gosh, like, I gotta get married first before having sex. I gotta wait for the right person. The best way to avoid HIV is to not have sex at all. Abstinence is the best policy, right? That's the kind of thing that adults want to stress. And I guess if you're a father or a mother, you have a 14-year-old daughter or a 14-year-old son, you just wish that that kid doesn't have sex, doesn't get pregnant, doesn't ruin his life with HIV or whatever, you know? So the wish is good. I respect that wish. But, you know, you can't expect the kid to not experiment or not do anything by either just lecturing them to them about it or not talking about it at all. Kids need to hear this stuff, like to be able to talk about this stuff. There are many misassumptions and concepts and ideas that they have because their hormones are raging now. This is the kind of things that they're so curious about that when they don't get to talk about it with adults, they'll end up talking about it or learning about it through some other way, through the internet, through movies and books, I don't know, magazines. There's all kind of things that they'll end up, guy in the street that they talk to, the creepy uncle that comes over for Thanksgiving. No, they'll end up talking about it, and the source that they're going to learn from is not always going to be the best source. So the best source to probably talk to them is an adult who is more open to talking about it and knowledgeable about it, like a social worker, a guidance counselor, a principal, a teacher, or a parent, or a not-so-creepy uncle who visits on Thanksgiving. I don't know, but it is extremely important to talk about. Just last Friday, you know, these are the kinds of misconceptions that kids can have. One of the questions the kids asked was, if you have cancer and you want to have sex, should you still have sex? That was one of the questions. And, right? Isn't that a weird kind of like, but these are the questions a kid can have. And so, you know, we discussed it pretty openly. Well, why do you ask that question? Why is it, you know, what does it matter if you have cancer and you want to have sex? You know, the assumption is that if you have cancer, you can spread it to another person by having sex with them. Isn't that wrong? You know, and so this whole, then we have to kind of talk about cancer. No, you can't really spread cancer. It's not a contagious disease. Kids are like, okay, well then, what if you're pregnant and you have cancer? Should you still have the kid? So again, no, cancer, you can't spread it that way. Can you get HIV or STD through kissing someone? You know, that's another, a big simple question that gets a lot of big discussion is, you know, should somebody wait until marriage to have sex? So that's a big question. Some kids are going to say yes, some kids are going to say no, and there's going to be disagreements, there's going to be all these opinions that are going to be talked about. And I think the important thing to keep in mind when talking with teenagers about sexuality, you know, you have your own values. These are things you want to tell them. Right, you think you have all these right answers, but I think in this topic, just telling them what is right and not to do, it's not necessarily the best course of action with teenagers because they don't want to be lectured to. But at the same time, you want to make sure that they have this, you know, they get this information about sexuality through the right people and not through the internet, for example, and not through pornographic websites. Because that can create all kinds of misconceptions. And so it's really important to talk about this topic. And like I said, it's a very broad topic. You know, for example, you know, what, this, it can get to pretty hairy territories. It can get to territory about rape, for example. Can men get raped? If a woman is wearing provocative clothes and is wanting to, you know, it's just saying, hey, you know, give me $20 and I'll have sex with you, you know, so prostitution becomes a topic. Rape becomes a topic. Can men get raped? Right? Like I said, if a woman is drunk and, you know, she's not really saying no, that you're approach, you know, that you're taking her clothes off, is that really rape? You know, if you're a teenager and you're a woman and you're pregnant, what should you do? You know, talking about sexual identity, you know, am I gay, am I bi, am I straight, I'm not sure, you know, these kind of are very important questions. Are you a man, are you a boy, what does your culture expect a boy to be, or a man to be, or woman to be? Should they act differently? Is it okay for a guy to wash dishes in your home? You know, these are questions of sexuality, and these are very important to discuss, I think, especially as a group of, you know, these wholly different teenagers from different families and different cultures and different values. They come together and they come to talk about it, and what seemed like this so totally uncomfortable, weird topic, at least there's some parts of it that are normalized in this discussion. And I think that's really what's extremely important. So, if you're an adult and you have a chance to talk to a teenager about these kinds of topics, do talk to teenagers about these sensitive, hairy topics. I think it's very important. But talk and not lecture. That's the important part. Anyway, that's what I wanted to say and ramble on about this topic. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.